vlogging today. I know it's been a little bit. Honestly, I've just been putting a lot of focus on the balance videos, and they've taken, the last two that we've done have taken hours to edit, which is fine because I love it, but it just like took up all my video creativity and I devoted it all to that. I thought today I would do kind of like a little life update intertwined with a full day of eating, being at home, so like a quarantine edition of a full day of eating. That's what we're doing today. I started my day with a liter of water, which is empty. I think I finished. An MCT coffee. I didn't want to bore you guys and show you how I make my coffee because I think I've shown it on every single video on this channel except for the Hawaii one and the first balanced leader search video. So if you're interested in how I make this, also please ignore my nails. I tried to pick this all off in the shower the other night and I think it kind of just looks like a French manicure, so it's really not the worst situation, but anyway, what was I saying? Yeah, we are pretty stocked up on food. We actually have a lot of healthy food too because we went to the store like 4 or 5 different times because each time they were out of so much. So going there that many times, we've compiled a lot of different healthy options. I'm gonna get some work done, drink my coffee, fast a little bit, and I will see you guys later when I make my breakfast, which I am obsessed with right now. So in a little bit. Also reading this book right now. I love Mark Hyman, like anything from him. But this is his new book and I could not recommend this anymore. It's one of the most eye-opening things I've ever read. And I truly believe that every human should know what's in this book to save our planet. Because if we don't change the way that food is produced and the way that we purchase food and what we put into our bodies, the earth is screwed in simple terms. So I recommend this, I'll link it down below, but it'll give you something to do while you're stuck at home. Made these immune shots the other day, and I just, whenever we like buy shots like this, I just keep the little bottles, but I'm gonna make more later, so I'll show you guys how I did it. All right, cheers.
Cheers.
They're very spicy.
Woo!
That was the last one I poured.
I don't need any coffee, this will wake me right up.
It cannot be that much spicier than mine. Oh, that's the last one.
This is like drinking Tabasco.
I'll take that one.
That's okay, I like the challenge.
Okay,
fine. You wanna go half and half? I'll give you 20 bucks if you pound the rest of this. Top to bottom.
They literally taste like a shot that you would get at like a juicery though. Yeah. And they literally probably cost like, I said on my story the other day, like 50 cents to make like 5 of them. And usually you pay like $4 for one. So my go-to breakfast recently has been scrambled eggs with kale. Kale just makes it really dense and we're trying to just like be mindful of how much food we're eating.
Yeah.
And so I've only been eating like 2 eggs a day, or like we've been eating 5 and usually we each eat 3. So way to like decrease the amount of eggs that we're eating a little bit, because we're also trying to eat a little bit less, is to boost the volume with a ton of kale. So, kale with a little bit of garlic powder, scramble the eggs, and then my little addiction right now, I'll show you guys when I'm done. Will you stop blessing the screen with your app? This is the butter that we use. I highly recommend anything from this brand. Very important to have open pasture, like pasture raised eggs. This brand, if you get their eggs, you can actually scan a barcode on the side and you can see a 360 view of the farm. You can like kind of walk around the farm.
That's so cool. Super cool. I did not know that.
Yeah, it's a new thing.
And what do you think you're doing?
Man. Frank is legitimately the star of the show.
He is. You know
what
he reminds me of?
What?
Mambo on Happy Feet.
Mambo Italiano.
So I just saute the kale a little bit until it cooks like 70% of the way with a little bit of grass-fed butter and a little bit of garlic powder, and then I'll add the eggs in and scramble.
So, have my eggs, I'm gonna put some avocado. This is literally the best combination ever. Somebody please try it. And then, the secret ingredient is everything bagel, seasoning, dip. I think you could probably make like a healthier version of this if you just use like grass-fed yogurt and then added everything bagel seasoning. But it's the simple things right now. It's the simple pleasures.
This is the real secret ingredient.
But not for this. No. Not for this. it with pink salt. It's literally the best thing ever.
I know it doesn't look like much, but it is.
It's the difference between me and Laur.
Yeah, mine's better.
Nah, false.
I'm gonna have some cereal for like some carbs, and also because I want something sweet. The ingredients in these are so good. And these are so good. If you ever see them in the store, highly recommend. And I'm just gonna use this almond milk. Oh. The best cereal. It's a little hard at first, so I always like to like let it soften for a minute, but yeah. All right, so I'm eating lunch. It is 2 o'clock. I had my breakfast at like 11:30. As always, and this is just leftovers from last night, and I added in some spinach when I heated it up. It's like, we had like a roasted veggie bowl, so it's sweet potatoes, tofu, sweet onion, peppers, Brussels sprouts, and then like I said, I mixed the spinach in. It's absolutely amazing. I have like a little tutorial on how I roast veggies in one of my last videos, so I'll make sure to link that below. But I'm just going to add some pink salt on top, organic tahini. I love the Trader Joe's tahini. And then also some hot sauce, of course. Avocado is also really good on this, but I already had a bunch this morning, so I'll save that for dinner. And on the side of this, I'm going to have a no-cal bar just because I'm really sore and I need protein, and we didn't have a ton of tofu left over, so definitely want to have some protein. So gonna eat this, work for a couple hours, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Got done making 5 immunity shots. Put them in old little shot bottles that we had. I always recommend saving these if you guys ever buy anything like this, because you never know when you're gonna use it, and it's better to save it no matter what than to throw it out, especially if you're not recycling it. I wanted to do a brief rundown of how I did this. If you guys saw on my Instagram a couple weeks ago how I juice without a juicer, it's basically the same thing, but with these I just make it a lot more potent. So I did 1 orange. I just use a blender this size too. You don't really need like a huge one. I did 1 orange, 1 lemon, and then a ton of ginger. I probably used a block of ginger like that big, I would say. Put it all in there, put water up to like there. You don't need a ton, but you do need a little if you're not using a juicer, just because you want to create some extra liquid. And then I use this bowl. I just washed it, which is why it's wet, but I use this bowl, and before I blended this and poured it into here in the nut milk bag, I added to the bowl just by itself some turmeric powder, some cayenne pepper powder, and also some black pepper. So I put these 3 seasonings in the bowl because turmeric will oftentimes stain a blender, like a clear blender, so I just put it in there. This is my nut milk bag, which I also just washed. It's kind of stained from different things that I've used, but after you have like your orange, lemon, ginger, etc., whatever you're using, you wanna blend it up, and then once it's all blended, you're just gonna pour it into the nut milk bag. So just kind of open it up, pour it in with all the seasonings and spices that you have, and then you'll just squeeze the bottom of the bag until all of the juice comes out and you only have pulp left in here. And you just want to rinse this really good with really hot water and then hang it somewhere to dry. And then over here you would have a bunch of strained liquid basically, and then I just pour them into the little bottles. And I like to use this bowl with a spout because it makes it really easy to pour. But yeah, super simple, absolutely amazing for you. It literally took me like 10 minutes to do. So highly recommend trying. If you guys end up trying this and you think of a good concoction, let me know. I'd be happy to try it. But yeah, I hope this was helpful. Just made some vegan peanut butter protein balls. Drowning in melted chocolate because I melted entirely too much. They are gluten-free, dairy-free, full of protein. They have a ton of healthy fats in them. I do not have a recipe because I always eye it up, and eventually I will be starting a company with these, so I don't want to share my secret recipe. To show you guys that I made them, I'm gonna let them chill so that the chocolate hardens, and have probably 2 of them as a little snack. Okay, so I forgot to vlog this, and we're like over halfway done, but Ben, focus. But Ben made us dinner, and it's so good.
came out the
grilled boxes. Wild caught mahi, cilantro lime rice, sauteed green beans. So yummy. Mm-hmm. Thanks, babe.
Of course.
Almost 6 and we started making dinner. We're really hungry, so we're gonna have like an early dinner tonight and it's gonna be so good. We're making butternut squash soup. It's a vegan, gluten-free, all the good things. Turkey burgers, we're gonna meal prep, and then I'm gonna make like a ginger creamy cashew sauce for the top of the turkey burgers. It's gonna be amazing. Always, I will have these recipes on the correlated blog, which is linked down below. The only recipe that won't be there is the turkey burger recipe because it's a recipe that's going to be my new program that will be available next week. So you can find every other recipe from today there, but not the turkey burgers. This is the start of the soup. I just roast butternut squash, carrots, and onion with a couple seasonings. All the details are in the blog. And yeah, once I do this, I'm gonna prep the turkey burgers. This will have to bake for like 45 minutes, so I'll get everything else ready while this is baking. I just prepped 6 organic turkey burgers. We only ended up doing 1 pack and we put the other one in the freezer. But yeah, like I said, this will be in my new program. This is one of my favorite meal prep recipes to make because it's super quick, super easy, so good. Yeah, they're so good. So yeah, stay tuned. I will be releasing it hopefully within 1 week of when you see this video. Butternut squash soup is done. Guys, this is seriously one of my favorite recipes I've ever created. I couldn't recommend it anymore. We have a little bit of jasmine rice. It's like kind of like coconut rice, and I really wanted that even though we have this because I made a creamy cashew ginger sauce for the turkey burgers, and I think that with the rice, and then we're considering this our veggie because it has a ton of onion in it, a ton of carrots. So we're considering this our veggie tonight, but yes, I could not be more excited. Ben is finishing the turkey burgers outside right now. So this is our dinner. We're each having 1.5 turkey burgers, avocado, cashew, ginger cream sauce, some jasmine rice, and then the butternut squash soup. This looks so good.
Oh my gosh,
I can't
wait. Yum. All right guys, that is going to wrap up the video. It was a little bit of an unorganized full day of eating, but it gets the job done. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you're new, make sure to subscribe. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and I will see you in my next video super soon.